craters. You can see the craters. Oh, spectacular. Okay, check this out. Check this out. What I'm seeing. Right through the eyepiece. Look at those craters, the details, awesome. Oh, look at that bird, did you see that? I think that was a bat. Here we go. That was wild. Now Jupiter is just peeking over the house. We're gonna take a look at Jupiter. All right, I can see all four moons, and I think one moon is about to transit. I believe it's Io. I think Io is either transiting or it just transited and it's going around. But you can see all four moons. I can see three color bands. I think the red dot is, or the red storm is on the other side of the planet right now. All right, the seeing conditions must be really good because I can see several color bands. I'm using the 10 millimeter eyepiece and all four moons are just blatantly obvious. And it's just right over there on the horizon. And seeing Jupiter is so awesome. Actually, let's see if I can show you guys. Now you may not be able to see detail, but you'll for sure see the moons.
Okay. It's hard to tell, there are the moons. Let's turn down the ISO. Hopefully you guys can see the...
What is up, everybody? Teagan here with High Point Scientific. Today we're going to be discussing the Sky-Watcher 130 and 150 Virtuoso GTi. Now, many of us at High Point Scientific, including myself, have experienced viewing Saturn's rings, Jupiter's red spot, the craters on the moon, as a first-time experience when, you know, looking through a telescope. Those are core memories that live within us and were the fuel that's, you know, sparked the fire that is now our passion for astronomy and astrophotography. So let's look at a few characteristics that the 130 and 150 Virtuoso GTi from Sky-Watcher have that enable you to have such an experience. So first and foremost, you want your first, even your second telescope to be user friendly. You want it to be easy to set up. You don't want to take 30, 45 minutes to set it up. You want it to provide you with some incredible results quickly and easily. The Virtuoso 130 and 150 absolutely hit this nail on the head. Now, like I said a couple of minutes ago, you want your first view through a telescope to be a mind-boggling, incredible experience. And the views through a 5-inch tabletop Dobsonian are just that. It's a big enough aperture to provide you some incredible detail on the planet, and you can see some of the brighter deep space objects. If you want to upgrade to the 150, this is a 6-inch mirror, there's a decent amount of light gathering power increase from the 130, so your views are just going to be that much brighter and more detailed. The third characteristic about the Virtuoso 130 that makes it so great is its portability and its reliability. If you want to go camping and you just want to take your scope along with you, or just hop out in the backyard, you know, sit it on a table, AA batteries are the way to go. I operated mine all night with 8 AA batteries. It's extremely reliable and extremely portable. Now, arguably one of the most important things to remember is the telescope that is best for you is the one that you're going to use the most. It was just so much fun to use and so easy. Now, all of that being said, let's go open up the box and check it out. Oh, and when I opened the scope, it was pretty much already assembled. All right, so we have the entire scope unboxed. Let's look at some of the accessories that come with it, and then we're gonna go over a short session on how to just set the whole scope up. You take the entire setup out of the box, and your accessories are a red dot finder scope, a collimation cap, a 25 millimeter and a 10 millimeter eyepiece, and obviously some nice instructions. After you unwrap the scope, you want to loosen the thumb screws on the side and extend the tube until it locks into place, and then tighten those thumb screws back down. Next, you want to balance the telescope by loosening the altitude clutch and pointing your scope horizontally so that the knob is facing upwards. Loosen that thumb screw carefully and make sure the scope is balanced from left to right by scooting the OTA back or forth. Tighten that thumb screw back down when you're finished. Now, attaching the red dot finder is also easy, but really important when you're doing your alignment under the stars. You want to use a Phillips screwdriver to loosen the screws on the side of the red dot finder and slide it into its bracket located towards the top of the scope. To calibrate your red dot finder scope to your eyepiece, insert your 25 millimeter eyepiece that comes with the scope. Loosen both your altitude and azimuth clutches and manually point to something low on the horizon like a car or a telephone pole. When you can view it through your eyepiece, rotate the focuser until you've achieved a nice focus. Power on your red dot finder, and then you can use the knobs on the side and the bottom of the red dot finder to center your red dot over the object that you're viewing through your eyepiece. Once you're finished, you have calibrated your red dot finder successfully. Now that your setup is finished, it's time to download the app and power on the scope itself. You can go power on your scope and then go to the Wi-Fi settings in your phone and select the Wi-Fi provided by the 130 or 150 Virtuoso. After that's been connected, you can go into your SynScan app, make sure you allow it to use your current location, and then select Connect at the top. Your phone should automatically connect to the app. All right, we are finally under the night sky. I'm gonna show you how to use the scope when you finally get it set up under the stars and how to navigate the SynScan app. First things first, let's go ahead and power our telescope. By clicking the red switch, you're gonna see a red light indicator pop up, and that just means that your telescope is now ready to connect to via your smartphone. Now tonight, I have Jupiter and I have Mars directly behind me. So what you wanna do is hit alignment and then brightest star alignment. Now it's going to ask me to select two bright stars, or in this case, two planets. So Jupiter, and then I'm going to select Mars. Now I'm going to click on Jupiter, and then I'm going to hit begin alignment. Now it says manually center Jupiter. So I'm going to manually point my scope towards Jupiter, make sure it's centered in my eyepiece. I'm going to loosen my altitude and my azimuth clutch, and use my red dot finder to make sure it's centered. All right, once that's centered, then you can tighten those clutches right back up. Go back into your app and hit the check mark. Now it's gonna automatically slew to Mars. It's moving by itself to Mars. And Mars is just to the left of that tree. I'm barely gonna make it, but it should be just perfectly visible. All right, now it's a little bit off, so now what I want to do is manually center it using the arrow pad on the app. You can increase your slew speed by hitting this top right arrow, and to adjust your scope up or down, left or right, you just hit the up, down, left, right arrows. All right, and when you have Mars centered in your eyepiece, go ahead and hit the check mark. It says alignment successful. All right, now that is the basic alignment process for that. Now you can literally search any object in the night sky that you want to. So let's go ahead and talk about some of the app features. First, let's go ahead back to the alignment tab. You have one star alignment, bright star alignment, three star alignment. You have several different options here, but some of them are more accurate than others. And for example, the one star alignment, if you just want to point to Jupiter and hit align, and you're good to go from there. But if you are looking for deep sky objects, you want your alignment and your go-to accuracy to be much more precise. So a three-star alignment, for instance, is going to be the best option for you in that case. But if you want something simple, a one-star alignment is perfectly fine. If you navigate back to the app, the home page, then you can hit the star icon. And this is going to allow you to choose solar system objects, name stars, double stars, and even comets. And then you can navigate back to the home page and you'll see the deep sky icon. From there, you can choose Messier catalogs, Caldwell, NGC, and IC catalog objects. So let's go to Messier, for example, and then we're going to select Messier 31. Populates up as the Andromeda Galaxy. And then you can hit the More button. And this is gonna give you basic information about the object. The name, the visual magnitude, the constellation that it lies in, what time it rises, what time it sets. This is all just great information if you plan a night out under the stars. Now finally, one of my favorite features of this app, if you go to the Utility button and hit Tonight's Best, it's going to give you a huge list of objects in the night sky that are visible right now given your time and location. Now you can navigate back to the homepage. All right, so that being said, that's basically all that you need to do to just navigate the night sky with your 130 Virtuoso GTi. Let's go back to the studio and recap. All right, well, that is the review of the Sky-Watcher 130 Virtuoso GTi, a go-to tabletop Dobsonian that blew me away with its views and its ease of use. Simply an incredible system and so simple to use with the smartphone app. Absolutely genius. So with that being said, if you have any questions, please let us know in the comments below. We'll be more than happy to assist. We hope that you liked this video. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel so you do not miss any of our future content. Thank you so much for viewing, and clear skies.